Hello, this is Dr. Ryan Bell with Yada Yada Pediatrics. Let's spend a few minutes talking about kids and hair loss. There's a few different categories that we try to identify when we get a chief complaint of hair loss in a pediatric patient. The most helpful thing usually is just to take a good look at the scalp. If the scalp seems healthy and normal skin that's just clearing out and there's not much hair there, then it points in the direction of it, the hair loss being caused by an autoimmune reason or a stressor. Kids that go through specific types of infections, sometimes real significant emotional stress, those things can cause a reaction that kids lose hair, especially in patches. The autoimmune causes would be things that generally come and go on their own within a fairly short time period. About half of kids with unexplained patches of hair loss will regrow that hair within a year time period with no other treatment or workup. The terminology alopecia areata describes a patch of hair loss, usually a circular patch of hair loss, usually caused for an autoimmune reason. Alopecia totalis is total hair loss, usually all of the hair on the scalp, as well as everywhere else on your body. That usually is an autoimmune cause as well. So those can be quite impressive. Often there's not a specific treatment for that, but again, in a lot of those cases, hair will regrow with time. Sometimes it doesn't. So if that scalp looks healthy, then you think, boy, has there been a stressor? Have they been sick? Have there been some significant emotional things? Or is this more likely to be an autoimmune trigger where that hair is just for unexplained reasons started to fall out in patches, usually circular patches? A family history can be an important clue. There's other autoimmune issues such as celiac disease, diabetes, thyroid problems. Then those kids in those families are going to be more likely to have some episodes of hair loss due to an autoimmune response. The other common area that we see as far as reasons for hair loss would be infections. We can get ringworm of the scalp, which is a fungal infection. We can also get bacterial infections that cause areas of hair loss. There's some characteristic findings on an exam where you look at that skin and it's not normal, healthy skin. There tends to be scaling there, thick, nasty stuff sometimes that's built up on the skin, or areas of pus and oozing and other signs of an infection that can affect those hair follicles. Treatment for those specific causes would obviously be antifungals or antibiotics. Often an antifungal needs to be taken by mouth because it's hard to treat infections down around the roots and the hair follicles. Unfortunately, a lot of those oral treatments take several weeks to sometimes several months to clear a fungal infection of the scalp or a ringworm infection of the scalp. Antibiotics tend to work a little quicker, and often an oral antibiotic, sometimes in addition to a topical antibiotic, will be effective in treating and clearing those infections. Another common thing you'll see causing hair loss, especially in younger kids or teenage girls, is what we call traction alopecia, where a tight hairdo, a hair weave, dreadlocks, something where you're pulling on that hair in order to style it and position it, that traction on the hair can lead to hair loss. And so if you notice it in patterns and you are doing something with the child's hair that causes some traction, simply changing those practices, changing hairstyles, will allow that hair to regrow. If there are more concerns or any complications with your child's hair loss, there's always the option to be referred to a specialist, usually a dermatologist. Sometimes there are specific treatments that they'll give you options for, including injectable steroids and other things to try to jumpstart that hair follicle to regrow a little quicker than leaving it alone. Sometimes there's some additional workup involved. Those are important things to consider when you're dealing with hair loss in your child. So check in with your pediatrician or your primary care provider if you have concerns about your child's hair loss.